mass frisking and checking. They go to some area and frisk 100 young people, mainly to prevent knife crime. But those are tactical things that you can do. All of you, many of you are doing it. I think police forces beginning to use Twitter now is a very good example. Bombay has done very well. Now UP is doing very well. I think Punjab, Haryana, all of them are doing it, because that what that does is that gives the citizen direct access, or at least a feeling that I have direct access to the top leadership. But that is not the solution. Solution also, I'm afraid, is not the Supreme Court mandated reform, police reforms, because Supreme Court lives in a different universe. They live in an ethereal, stratospheric world. They think that by giving orders, they can create the perfect world. It doesn't happen. They've tried to run the Medical Council of India. See how much humiliation the Supreme Court itself has faced in that. Government has set aside all their clearances. The committee that the Supreme Court set up under a former Chief Justice of India has dismantled itself. After that, allegations have come up. In fact, these are allegations in which the Chief Justice himself was targeted, and he had to personally intervene to finish that case, that in clearance of one of these medical colleges, money was either passed or was sought to be passed on to higher judges. So governing cannot be done, governance reform cannot be done by court orders. I think we are all being lazy if we think the Supreme Court ne bola hai. First of all, it's not binding on the states, it's a state subject, and nobody will do it. Second, it will not be done like that. I think one, there is some citizen pressure coming up, but essentially this pressure will have to come from professional policemen, because there are many things that the police needs to do. First of all, you need more officers. Indian police has too few officers. Your academies are too small. Your intakes are too small. The number of policemen as a percentage of population is too small. The facilities available to your people in police stations, even in Delhi, look at the way policemen sleep at night. Fans don't work. Basic facilities are not there. Our police stations in most of the country, barring the big cities, are worse than slums. That is where suspects are kept. That's where records are kept. Half the crimes, one of the reason conviction rates is so low is because documents disappear, evidence disappears. Our forensic labs are a national embarrassment. You know, Shashi Tharoor's wife died many years ago. Delhi police commissioner said it's a murder. The fact is, in 2017, 3 years, 4 years after we sent an orbiter to Mars, we are still sending her viscera for testing to FBI. I mean, what kind of a country are we? And what kind of policing do we have? It is a joke. I mean, to say that India does not have a lab to analyze a viscera, when India has the labs to now do break down the genome, break down your gene and say, you know, in 7 generations back, you have such and such genes in your bloodline, et cetera, et cetera. Why can't you have a lab? Why can't there be a reform like allow accrediting 100 path labs in the country with doing basic forensic work? Just send viscera samples there, blood samples there, anything. The waiting list in your forensic labs, I believe, is now anything from 3 months to 2 years. And by the time the samples come, the samples lose all value. They come tied in pieces of cloth. They are falling apart. I have covered courts in serious criminal cases, and I know that, you know, it's very evident that most of these cases will go away. So citizen then goes back thinking, ke police ka haath nahi padna chahiye, because main 10 saal barbaad hoonga, mere paise barbaad hoenge, lawyers will get rich, and in the end, justice will not get done. So I think instead of focusing on getting reform from the politicians and using the Supreme Court to do it, it will not happen, I guarantee it to you. Because one, Supreme Court doesn't have the power to do it. Second, nobody will listen to it. Supreme Court cannot send home secretaries of 31 states to jail. Even if it does, reform will not take place, I'm telling you. But you have to start work on reform at operational levels. Make citizens your consumers. They are your consumers, but give them better consumer satisfaction. And I think from there, and say, डोंट बी सो मिनिमलिस्टिक जस्ट टू से कि हमारा पुलिस कप्तान चोरी नहीं करता है या अपने घर में अपनी भैंसों में पुलिस के जवानों से काम नहीं कराता है राइट दैट इज़ ए मिनिमलिस्टिक एक्सपेक्टेशन सो से दैट फील फ्री टू गो टू द पुलिस एंड कैरी आउट सम लिटिल बिट ऑफ एजुकेशन गो टू स्कूल्स टेल पीपल टेल पेरेंट्स नॉट टू टेल देयर चिल्ड्रन दूध पी लो नहीं तो पुलिस वाला आ जाएगा राइट इट्स दीज आर स्टीरियोटाइप्स दैट वी हैव बिल्ट ओवर टाइम सो आई थिंक द की थिंग इज टू रिड्यूस द I mean, it's a contradiction. At the same time, we want people to fear the police and respect the police, but it has to be worked in such a way that people respect the law and they fear the law, but they treat the law enforcers as their allies instead of enemies. And for the only way that can happen is to reduce this friction between police and the citizen. The biggest problem in our country, people are angry because when they have to deal with the government, with the state, they find friction. See, all of us live in private homes. We have private generators for power, private borewells for water, private security outside our homes. We drive private cars. We don't use public transport. Our children go to private schools. When we get sick, we go to private hospitals. We have nothing to do with government. We have all seceded from the government. So we only interact with the government when it comes to paying taxes, negative, getting a driving license renewed, line pe lagna padta hai. वहाँ पे एक आँख टेस्ट करने वाला भी बैठा होता है आरटीओ के बाहर वो कहता है जी आपको आईज का सर्टिफिकेट चाहिए अब टेस्ट करना है टेस्ट कैसे करो कि आप जाओ मेरा पास तो एमबीबीएस है और ऑफ्थेल्मोलॉजी का मैंने डिप्लोमा किया हुआ है आई विल गिव यू अ सर्टिफिकेट सेइंग आपकी आँख ठीक ठाक है राइट सो एनी इंटरेक्शन दैट वी हैव विद द गवर्नमेंट इंक्लूड स्पेशली द पुलिस मीन्स फ्रिक्शन इट इज नेगेटिव टुडे वी हैव कम टू अ सिचुएशन वेयर इन योर मेल बॉक्स इफ यू गेट अ लेटर फ्रॉम द गवर्नमेंट with service stamps or anything with the government, your heart skips a beat because you think ya koi police ki FIR hogi ya chalan hoga traffic ka ya tax ka notice hoga. We never get good news from the government. When I say this to tax people that you know every year when a citizen's tax is return is assessed and found in order, send him a nice note saying thank you very much, your taxes are in order, we accept this return. Because 99.9% returns are accepted as they are, but that will never come. You will only get a letter when they'll say, "Aake humko explain karo." So these are areas where I think big improvements have to be carried out in all wings of the government, but especially the police. A policeman knocking at your door doesn't necessarily mean I'll just take a minute more. I see the robust side of Indian policing. I've seen it as a reporter. I've also seen it as a citizen. I am a late night person. हम लोग बोलते हैं कि हमारे पे wrong allegation है कि we start our day late. We work 9 to 9, but London time. So we, my wife and I stroll happily 32 in our colony, and we've lived in the same colony since 89 now, 28 years. And right through two sets of people we've been friends with, all the street dogs, and you know many of us have made sure that all the dogs are vaccinated and neutered and friendly. So they walk from one territory to the other, and then the other, you know, the dogs have territories, and our beat constables. So our beat constables have always been our buddies. We even know them by name. Ever since WhatsApp has come, my beat constables have me on WhatsApp, right? Keep sending information, including WhatsApp forwards or faltu WhatsApp forwards, and I see how knowledgeable they are. तो दिल से जी फलाना साहब के तो गार्ड बाहर सोते रहते हैं फलाना साहब के तो उनके गार्ड तो बाहर रात में जुआ खेलते हैं उनकी गाड़ी देखिए बाहर खड़ी थी हमने उनको बोल दिया उसको अंदर रखें उन्होंने 3 बार माना नहीं चौथे दिन चोरी हो गई सो आई नो दैट दीज आर ओल्ड रोबस्ट सिस्टम्स ऑफ पुलिसिंग दैट रियली वर्क सो इफ सम गॉड फॉरबिड समथिंग डज हैपन इन दिस एनी लोकेलिटी द बीट कॉन्स्टेबल विल नो द हिस्ट्री ज्योग्राफी फिजियोलॉजी पैथोलॉजी etc of almost everybody there they even know ki kiska kiske sath affair ho raha hai kaun kiske sath gaya tha sab pata hota hai un logo ko but so there are it's not as if everything is broken I think a lot works I find in the villages chowkidari system works I saw it in Punjab during terrorism in the villages chowkidari system working so all this works so build on this but modernize the systems before the politicians do something they'll do something when they want when somebody gets up the right side of the bed but politicians usually don't so they'll do it when they do it but at your own end please improve bring in operational efficiencies and operational smoothness, so this friction comes down. I think on that note, I shall conclude.
Thank you, Mr. Shekhar Gupta. Now we are right on the time. It's 1:30, but I think with the approval of the chair as well as the house, I think the house is open for 10 minutes question answer.
Good afternoon, sirs. I am Subhash Sinha, looking after the duties of DIG of CISF headquarters. My submission is regarding the issue of staff satisfaction raised by DGCRPF. As has been talked on the panel right now, and also what we have been reading, the macro level changes will take a lot of time. But there are certain micro level changes that, at my level of understanding, the police leadership can adopt. For example, sir, we tend to condemn the grassroots constable or the ASI or Havaldar for example, being overweight. Recently, I read one article by one district SP who said that if you reduce by 5 kg, we'll give you a choice posting. So a disincentive, instead of a disincentive, it becomes a positive incentive. The second example, that is the only second example and the last example that I will take, sir. For example, the case of a police medal. Police medal says, for the last 10 years, you are not supposed to have a minor penalty. Now, in case, that's my submission, my level of understanding, that if
you need to be short, please.
In case there is a punishment, and after that, that person does very well, he should have some incentive regarding that. Thank you, sir.
Mr. Bhatt, sir.
Actually, what you are saying does not actually require any answer. My point was that we do go to the public, but like we must go to our own people also, because they are the ones who are going to deliver that service. So we need to go them and go them also in a systematic manner. Thank you.
Any more? No questions? Anyway, the house is satisfied. So it's lunchtime also. Thank you very much. Oh.
Yeah. How can a citizen become a better policeman?
See, I know this question keeps coming up all the time, and for a long time, even while I covered crime, I wasn't aware that a citizen has the power to arrest. You can carry out a citizen's arrest. So I sometimes joke now, when some of our warrior channels, commando comic channels, and ekdo hamari jo roz raat ko Pakistan ko tabah kar deti hai, to wo usme ek bar kisi ke piche pad gaye the ki ji ab Pakistan gaye, ab Hafiz Saeed ko kyon mile. So in fact, after that, I wrote an article ki dekho, main to Bhindranwale ko har hafte milta tha. Shukar hai wo purana zamana tha. Aaj ka zamana hota to there would have been pressure on me either to snatch somebody's AK and shoot him, right, or to put him under citizen's arrest, right? So could I have put Bhindranwale under citizen's arrest? So I think citizens, just if they're just vigilant, I think a few things are required. We are too large a country for this promiscuity among citizens to start policing. That will become dangerous also, because we are diverse. Caste will come in, religion will come in, mutual suspicions, neighborhood disputes, all that will come in. But the important thing is, people have to understand the basic rules and hygiene of policing. And one of the simplest things, which I think every police force in the country and resources will be available through government advertising, through social media, please respect the crime scene. In our country, nobody respects the crime scene, including the media. In fact, especially the media. Kahi murder hota hai, terror attack hota hai. You see these guys just walking all over the place. I mean, even if you look at this Arushi murder case, the big problem with Arushi murder case is that the crime scene was completely
ruined. Hundreds of people had walked in and out. It showed ignorance of the police's part, but also common citizens, media, anybody walks in anywhere. There is no system, so, and these are things that people will understand very quickly. Similarly, people have to understand basic principles of policing, crime, responding to crime, who to call. I am very happy that increasingly now state governments are paying attention to where their 100 numbers, because that's the first contact when something happens. You see, for me also, I have now lived in Delhi for 34 years as a journalist. I've spent a lot of my time with policemen. Rama and I knew each other in 1981 in Assam on his first posting when I was covering the Northeast. So we go back with lots of policemen at the same time. When something happens in my neighborhood or something happens to us, we've had 3 burglaries, the first instinct is to call the police commissioner or call the policeman, senior police officer who you know. The first instinct is not to call 100 because you think koi kuch karega hi nahi. But I am finding that in Delhi, this is now getting better. I don't know, I think some other states are also getting better. So these are areas which have to become better. But really, you know, I see your policemen, officers as well as men, they are under too much pressure. There is too much work. There are too few people and the training is much too poor. Too much is still done in Urdu. They may write in Devanagari. Mujhe abhi fir court jana hai. Hamare ghar ek choti si burglary hui thi. Wo saman mil gaya hai. Supurdari. Now, an ordinary citizen doesn't understand what is supurdari. Supurdari means aapko supurd karega saman. But I have to go to court, I have to sign an affidavit, written in some insulting English, right? All bad spelling, right? Uske baad aap mujhe khada hona hai, uske baad court ka clerk ka bhi usme arbitrage hai. So I think citizens have to be made more aware of how they can contribute to make policing smoother in their own interest, keep their eyes and ears open, report when they see something unusual. But they will also do it when they are confident that at the other end, somebody will make use of this. Because I think a lot of times of terrorism, what people notice very often is the FIR that can prevent a crime.
With this, I think I, on behalf of BBRND, would like to thank each of the speakers on the dais, as well as the audience, who has been very enthusiastic. And now, with the permission of the DG BBRND, I request you all to join us for the lunch.
Before that, I must request you all, and thank you once again, ladies and gentlemen, you have been with us since morning. We had the culminating session post-lunch. It may not be a good idea to many of us, having a session, but Mr. Amitabh Kant, we particularly called him because when he's talking of the land issues and the way the smart cities would be tackling it, and there are certain other developmental aspects of policing, whether it is tourism for India or whatever, and I think it will be a very fruitful session, so we'll request you to be with us even after lunch. And before that, please give a big applause for the whole panel, Mr. Shekhar Gupta, Mr. Bhatnagar, and Mr. Ramchandran. And a small memento I am presenting to them, and thereafter we go for the lunch. Thank you very much.
Been the recipient of a number of awards, which include the Economic Time Policy Change Agent of the Year Award, the Bloomberg TV Personality of the Year Award, the NDTV Administrator of the Year Award, the Distinguished Fellowship of the Institute of Directors. He is also the recipient of One Globe Award 2016 for leadership in transforming governance for the 21st century. He also is the recipient of Sir Edmund Hillary Fellowship Award by the Prime Minister of New Zealand of New Zealand. He is also the recipient of the Golden Peacock Award for Leadership in Economic Transformation 2017. Shri Amitabh Kant has worked as CMD, ITDC, Joint Secretary, Ministry of Tourism, Government of India, Secretary of Tourism, Government of Kerala, Managing Director, Kerala State Industrial Development Corporation, also as District Collector, Kozhikode, and Managing Director, Matsyagarh. Shri Kant did his schooling from Modern School, Delhi, and his graduation from the prestigious St. Stephen's College, Delhi University. We welcome you, sir. Our second speaker is Shri Sudhir Pratap Singh. He is an IPS of the 1983 batch, Rajasthan Cadre, and joined the National Security Guards in September 2016 as the Director General. Prior to joining NSG, Shri Singh worked as ADG Training, CRPF, New Delhi. In his parent cadre, Shri SP Singh has served in Rajasthan Police in various capacities. During his tenure on Central Deputation, Shri Sudhir Pratap Singh served as CBI as DIG, in CISF as Inspector General North Sector, and in CRPF as Inspector General Srinagar Sector, Jammu and Kashmir. He has been conferred with Police Medal for Meritorious Service in the year 2000 and the President's Police Medal for Distinguished Service in 2007. I welcome you both, sirs. And now I would request Shri Amitabh Kant, sir, to give his talk.
Mr. Maheshwari, Mr. Singh, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, it's a great pleasure for me to be here at the Dr. Anand Swarup Gupta Memorial Lecture Series. Let me first compliment the DGB, BPR&D, for this unique lecture series. I just discovered, actually, that Dr. Anand Swarup Gupta was the father of a very distinguished senior colleague of mine, Mr. Deepak Gupta, with whom I've had the pleasure of working, and I've had the pleasure of playing golf with him on many occasions. And I was delighted to learn that actually Dr. Anand Swarup Gupta got into the Indian Police Service due to a very providential combination of circumstances and events, somewhat against his inclination. But once he got into the police service, he gave it all to his profession. He gave his whole life to this profession. And he was a very brave and intrepid police officer who went on to become a very celebrated police historian. And not only was he a great police historian and a great police officer, but he was a person who wrote spiritual poetry, could recite Shakespeare, Ghalib, and Bhagavad Gita with equal facility. So it's a great pleasure and a great honor to be here on the occasion of the Dr. Anand Swarup Gupta Memorial Lecture Series. DGBPR&D asked me to speak on neo-policing formats for developing incredible India and smart cities. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the age of urbanization. Actually, cities occupy just 3% of the earth landmass, but they account for almost 82% of the global GDP. 82% of the global GDP comes from cities. But cities also account for 78% of the CO2 emissions. As I speak here today, every minute in India, there are 30 Indians who move from rural areas to urban areas. If you go by the latest McKinsey study on urbanization in India, by 2050, you will have an additional 700 million Indians getting into Indian cities. 700 million additional Indians. And actually, India will do more urbanization in the next 5 decades than what it has done in the last 5,000 years. But the challenge is that when urbanization happened in America, when it happened in Europe, land, gas, and water were all cheaply available. And because they were cheaply available, America had the luxury of living in New Jersey, traveling to New York, guzzling gas. They could create huge, big limousines. Gas was virtually free, so you could guzzle gas. So Americans created cities like Atlanta, where 99% of the people travel by cars. So American cities were designed for cars and not for people. If India is to follow that model of the American concept of urbanization, then actually the world would need four planet Earth. Four planet Earth. But you don't have four planet Earth, you have only one planet Earth. And therefore, you need very innovative and very sustainable urbanization. The process of urbanization has ended across America. It's ended across Europe. It's nearing its completion in China, where all kind of mistakes of repeating the Western model of urbanization have been made. But the process has just begun in India. And actually, India has the possibility of doing some unique, innovative, and sustainable urbanization, which can then become the model for the rest of the world. And therefore, many of these lessons of how smart policing is done, or how we manage urban cities, or how we create cities, do not come from the western part of the world, they come from the eastern part of the world. They come from a city called Kitakyushu in Japan, where in late 70s, the women of Kitakyushu actually rose in revolt because Kitakyushu drove the urbanization, drove the advancement of Japan as an industrial power in the 60s and 70s, post-World War II. But it became, the Dokai Bay on which it is based, became one of the most polluting cities of the world. And therefore, it became from blue, it became absolutely yellow, exactly like Delhi is some of this time, and the women of Kitakyushu actually rose in revolt. And the Ministry of Trade and Industry of Japan was forced to work with the women of Kitakyushu to create a completely new city. And actually, if you go to Kitakyushu today, it's one of the smartest cities in the world. Everything is recycled, from automobile to mobiles to construction material to food, and everything is recycled. Or they come from, the other great example is of Yokohama, where a woman mayor was able to reduce waste by segregation at household level by almost 39%. Or they come from a great example of good compact, instead of sprawling urbanization, of dense compact urbanization, comes from Singapore, where they recycle every drop of water, and almost 10% of the water, of wastewater, is actually used for human consumption. The president and prime minister drink water which is treated water from your waistlines. Or they come from Curitiba in Latin America, where within 2 minutes, every person living in that city is able to access a bus. So public transportation is the key. So cities will increasingly get designed for buses and for public transportation. India has been a very reluctant urbanizer because of our belief in our founding father, believe that our India will live in its villages. But increasingly people move from to urban areas. And this is the first government which is openly talking about urbanization, and therefore the talk of 100 smart cities which are under implementation. Therefore, getting 50 metros implemented across cities, and therefore India is in the wave of a huge urbanization process. And what it will do to many aspects of